Honorable members, I welcome you all and summon you to another year of hard work in the service of the nation. We begin the year on a confident note, having responded with determination to the unforeseen and stupendous challenges of the last 4 years. In the face of continuing rise in prices, the foremost concern of government in 2004 was to impart a measure of stability to the economy. Government adopted a comprehensive strategy to control inflation, and this was put into operation from July 2004. Besides increased mobilization of resources and economies in non-plan expenditure, money supply was restricted through an appropriate monetary policy. A vigorous drive was launched against economic offenses like smuggling, hoarding, and tax evasion, and against spurious units indulging in malpractices in scarce materials. Consumer expenditure was restrained by limiting dividend incomes and impounding increase in wages and salaries under part of additional dearness allowance. Public distribution was strengthened and arrangements were made for adequate import of food grains and essential raw materials and commodities. The annual plan for 2004-05 was received and outlays on the core sectors were raised to boost production. Vigorous action was also taken to improve utilization of capacity in power plants, rail transport, coal production, steel plants, and other public sector industries. This concerted action began to yield results towards the end of September 2004, despite an unsatisfactory kharif crop caused by poor rainfall in many states. Prices began to fall and there has been a weakening of the inflationary forces. The availability of essential goods has generally improved. The general outlook for the Rabi crop is good. Production in public enterprises has shown a significant rise in the first 9 months of this financial year. 14% more electricity is being produced by thermal plants, an improvement of 34% in the production of power by DVC plants merits special mention. Since shortage of power still persists in a number of states, high priority is being given to the completion of power projects. About 2 million kilometers of power capacity is being added in 2004 and another 3 million in the coming year. 10 million tons more coal will be produced this year. The production is going up. Public sector engineering industries are doing remarkably well. More railway wagons are being moved daily. I congratulate workers, farmers, and other sections of the people for their determination, courage, and identity with national purpose shown by them in supporting the government program of economic stabilization. Government is aware that there is no room for complacency as there are still sizable imbalances between supply and demand in several important sectors of the economy. The international economic situation is also full of uncertainties. The monetary and fiscal measures and the action against economic offenses will be continued with vigor. Simultaneously, government will intensify measures to remove limitations in the infrastructure and to increase production in vital sectors. In the international sphere, we shall continue to work for the evolution of a just and viable economic order in cooperation with developing countries as well as developed countries which have shown understanding of our problems. We have been hit hard by the sudden and large increase in the prices of oil, food and fertilizers. Articles of common consumption have been affected and great hardship has been caused to the people. There is a very heavy draft on foreign exchange. Even a significant increase in our export earnings is not adequate to fill the gap. Special efforts and arguments are necessary to deal with the problems of oil importing developing countries. Some of the oil exporting countries have helped us in this regard. There has also been some action at the international level, but these measures fall short of the needs of the situation. The severe damage caused to the economies of developing countries has to be recognized and redressed through purposeful cooperative effort on a global scale. We shall continue to take appropriate initiatives in this direction, both through bilateral negotiations and in international forums. In addition to the emphasis on increased production and use of coal, we are going ahead with oil exploration on an urgent basis. The recent discoveries in the offshore Bombay High structure are promising. Government has decided that this oil field should be developed to the production stage with the greatest expedition. It is being planned that the first stage of production should begin in 2006 and that in another 4 years, the production from this area should go up to 10 million tons. The future outlook for production of oil from offshore and onshore area is resuming. There is understandably some anxiety about the 10th five-year plan. A plan has a framework and a coherent system of objectives as well as a detailed program indicating targets and the availability of resources.